Cool. Only thoughtful. Namaste, friends. You're back for another episode of Dear Do here at None and All Now on YouTube. Brought to you by the Institution of None and All. You can find us on Facebook. On Facebook, through the Institution of None and All, we have what is I calling Cyber Sangha. Cyber Sangha. And in our Cyber Sangha, we have friends. Yes, we have very many friends. They are nice people. We like them. And one of them is Wave 1111. Check out Wave 1111 on Facebook. She's a good page. This is a great page. Okay. Wave 1111. Asking a question to None and All Now, Dear Dude. And the question is, how do we resolve duality? This is an interesting question. And really what they are asking, I believe, is how do we benefit? Ultimately, this is the end of the question, I believe. How do you benefit from the installation of a Tai Chi worldview in the modern world? The short answer for that is you do not. I believe Tai Chi is just a Chinese way of expressing a pattern which is static in the universe. This is an Asian worldview. This is rumored to be what Yeshua was teaching in the West. Actually, this is not a rumor. This is pretty much, you think, no matter who you are, the chance that Jesus, who is Yeshua, is teaching to Western style people a kind of interfaith method, a kind of Eastern philosophy, you would be correct. That's exactly what's happening. So this is, you know, this is None and All Now, and we're going to do a little thing called Tai Chi, Advaita, Shivalinga. Shivaling. Shivling. Okay. Basically, in the beginning of the universe, there was a way it was. We've done videos on this already. We won't give you the long version, but basically there was, at, you know, like they say, at first it's just nothing, wuji, and then after it became something, you had tai chi. And that is that as soon as the nothing became something, the universe was born. And the first thing that happened is out of that darkness came consciousness, and then the second thing that was born was a light within the conscious darkness that experienced itself, and the universe around it experienced itself. So the darkness was having an experience and the light was having an experience, and the relationship between those two things is the entire, the rest of the universe is based on that. Okay, that's why everyone thinks, you know, light is so important. The Western worldview, though, is very, very, very much concerned about achieving some kind of absolute resolution to this thing. The Eastern worldview is not trying to achieve resolution. So the question is, as I believe his name is Thunderfoot, the guy who was arguing with Eric Hoven, would say, it's a malformed question. The question, you can't reconcile this. You can recognize it. When you recognize it, that is what Tai Chi, the IV, is supposed to be. You know, Tai Chi is not the duality. The duality is the mistake. The duality is the illusion. The realization is the totality, not the duality. The realization is the unity. The realization is the relationship. The realization is the boundary around the whole thing. You know, it's all of it, and how it all relates to itself. And if you ask physicists how is the world, you know, designed, they'll tell you, like, this little white tail is like dropping out of sight behind the black swell, right? Here's a black swell right here. So then this little white tail drop out of sight behind that, and it comes up right in the center of the black swell, right in the center of it right there. That's where the white tail, it goes down around this one and comes up right there, and that's a hole that drops into this thing, and then this thing's a swell, right? This is a big swell, and then this black tail is a hole, drops down around back there, comes right there, there's a tail to the hole, right? That's how the universe works. That's how the universe is built on itself. So physicists have found Tai Chi in the universe. That's what Carl Sagan and everybody out there is trying to tell you, is that, like, when you look out into space, man, it's like the same as taking pictures of, like, muddy water real close up or your body or any number of other things that you could just take a picture of really close up. You'd get the same thing as really far away, because sooner or later you see the whole universe come back to itself. The wrong idea is that it just goes on and on and on and on and on and on and on. It does, but it doesn't go on and on and on and on and on in, like, distance and length and feet and shit. That's not how this works at all. You know, that's, like, completely wrong. So, at any rate, moving on. This is Advaita. When you realize that these two things are each other's complement, not opposite. They're not fighting for things. You know, it's not. There's no inequality between them. The universe is already balanced. It just balances itself. It doesn't. It's not balanced. It balances. That's what it does. It balances. Everything is. So that's why the planets move like they do, and space moves like it does, and everything. And your worldview in the West isn't based off this at all. Your numbers, your math, your science, everything you have, it's not really, it very, 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 very grotesquely always arrives back at this, but it's not based on this. So that's one of the reasons that your shit doesn't work. You know, you guys are good engineers and nothing else. You know, you can make stuff, but you can't resolve any other questions about things, really. Everything is only coming down to -1 or +1 or 0. Tai Chi, like, right? I mean, come on. So, like, electromagnetics, you know, like, negative, positive, you can't have, like, not one. You know what I'm saying? You can't, like, have not one. This is how amino acids form in cells, like in transcription RNA and messenger RNA and your DNA. This is how it all works right here. See, this is how you make a baby. This is a baby. This is everything in the world right here, you know? Cups with stuff in them. You know, that's the universal reality. Can I get the fuck out of here, man? What the fuck? You're interrupting me? Oh. Anyways, that's the thing, man. You get stuff with just, that's it, stuff. Stuff inside of stuff. Everything's a container. You know, it's all empty cups all the way up and down this whole motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? And it's built on top of itself. So the idea that space just goes out forever, right? It does, right? But, like, it goes in forever too, right? So, like, shit gets smaller and smaller and smaller at every level also, right? That's your worldview, right? You have that worldview, right? You have it for a reason, right? I think the whole thing is a big, you know, you guys are all just confused looking for the wrong stuff. You're trying to figure out what's out there. You can't figure out what's right here. You know, you can't figure out your who are you? Who are you? Why are you here? How'd you get here? What were you before you were this? What are you going to be after you this? Why are you this? Why is things this way? What is this world? Why are you here? And what? Where did you come from? These are all questions that you're completely incapable of answering or asking. And then that's not even really necessary, right? If you understand the universe, who cares? It doesn't really matter, does it? So anyways, Advaita is a... When you have Advaita, you realize that the universe does what it's supposed to. And if you have faith in the magic, if you have faith in the power, and the power is good because of your karma, there's no other way. Like, you get what you give. You know what I'm saying? Your life is what you put into it. So if you're not putting something into it, what do you expect to get? If you're not taking something out of it, what do you expect to get? Now you've got to understand this. That's why everything is always taking, first of all, two forms, then four forms. Breaking out, getting bigger, okay? So let's say you're you know, kids, all right? You love your kids. That means you want to stop them from doing things, right? What do you do? Do you let your kids do things? Do you not let your kids do things? Where do you draw a line, right? The idea is that, oh, I can just do something and that will be it. Boom! Problem solved. But that's not it. It's not, you know. So, like, kids are not listening. Try to be nice. Kids are still not listening. Be medium nice. Kids are still not listening. Start yelling at them! Then kids, maybe they start listening now. That's how you do it, right? That's what you have to do, right? But that doesn't mean that you fucking, you know, come on, don't go crazy. And so, like, people are thinking, like, for example, bipolarness, you know what I'm saying? They're thinking, oh, I'm bipolar. Good. You're supposed to feel emotion, you know, way back and forth. This is good for you, right? This is the problem with Tai Chi. If everybody realized Tai Chi, the world would be out of problems. Because everyone would know how to balance the problems. You know? Where would everybody be working then? You know? Who would be going to therapy if everyone didn't need it? You know? Then what would the therapist be doing? They wouldn't have jobs. Well, yeah, like, what if people didn't need to be educated because people were free to go to the library, read the books, get on the checkboard? Make calculations, ask people, hey, what's up, man? How do you do this? How do you do this? How do you do? How did you do? How did you do? How did you do? How did you do? But you have a university where teacher says, you could have everything be free. Everything would be perfect. Life would be perfect. No one would have to have a job. You would still have progress, and you would still have all kinds of exciting things to do. People would make things because they have time on their hands, because life is there, you know? And everyone could just do whatever they want. You know? If you had Tai Chi, that would be the way the world was. But nobody understands it. Nobody understands Advaita. Nobody understands Shivling. How is this? Everybody over here saying love and light and love and light. No, you know, this is just, it's too much. So what you have to do is you have to come on, see that the universe is just this way. It's just this way, and see things in the totality of it, and then see how things expand from there. And we'll go on to it more, and I'll talk about it other times, you know? But that's it. You're good. Ciao, ciao.